Hi. In this video, I'm going to show you something that arises when you do a tau series solution to a differential equation, and you end up with two or three tau series with different taus of x or of t, and you need to merge them together, so you have to change the indices, and that's what I'm going to show you, how to change the indices so that the tau series can be combined together. All right, so suppose you have this equation. Y double prime minus xy is equal to zero. And then suppose some initial conditions. I'm not gonna go through the whole thing. I'm gonna stop at the changing of the indices. So let's just say that y of zero is equal to let's say one, and y prime of zero is, let's say, equals to one also. But in a way, it doesn't really matter, because we're not gonna get that far. All right, so we're gonna do tau series. Y is equal to sum of a n x to the n, n goes from zero to infinity. Y prime is gonna be n a sub n x to the n minus one after you take the derivative. And because a zero is gone, this one starts at one. And then you take the second derivative, n times n minus one, a sub n x to the n minus two, and the summation goes from two to infinity because both a naught and a one are gone by the derivatives, right? This one is a naught plus a one x plus a two x squared plus etc. You take one derivative and you lose. You don't have the a naught anymore. You take the derivative of this one, and the a1's gone. A1's gone, so you have this left, 2a2 plus et cetera. Okay, so that's why the index of y prime starts at one, and the index for y2 starts at two. Sorry, y double prime. The index for y prime starts at one, and the index for y double prime starts at two. And x times y is gonna be x times n from zero to infinity, a n x n. And you multiply x inside, so basically it's a sum, right? So you distribute x over every single one of these. So for every single one of the term, you have an extra x. So think of it like a distribution of x over this sum, n from zero to infinity of a n x to the n plus one. So y double prime minus xy is gonna be equal to y double prime right here. I'm gonna copy it down. Sum from n equals two to infinity, and n minus one, a n x n minus two, minus x y, which is this line right here, so I put that in, n equals zero to infinity of a n x to the n plus one. Okay. So here's the problem. The problem is, if I want to merge these two together into one big summation, then it's like in algebra when you add two polynomials. What you need to do is to combine like terms, right? If you're gonna have an x to the fifth over here, then you have combined it to the x over fifth over there, not with x to the fourth or x to the third. So for example, what we have here is a problem that this is x to the n minus 2 and this x to the n plus 1. So we need to make them both like terms. If they're not like terms, we cannot combine them. So the key is we need to match these. Right? So different people do it differently. I'm going to show you one way. So I'm going to use something that's like. Like a substitution. Which really what it is, okay? Once you get used to it, once you get good at it, you can do it without all the small steps. But I'm gonna do with all the small steps. So for the first sum, for both of them, I want to end up with x to the n on both. So I do a substitution where first I put in a k and later on I rename k as n. Okay. So for the first summation, I have sum n from 2 to infinity and n minus 1 a n x to the n minus 2. And here's the key. The key is I want this to be n. So when you first get started, you may get confused between a new n and old n, etc. So let's use a different letter. So I'll call this k. So my k is going to be equal to n minus 2. That means n is going to be k plus 2. And when n equals 2, when n is equal to 2, then k is 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. So now I substitute. Actually, officially speaking, there's also this step. When n gets to infinity, then k also gets to infinity. Right, now I substitute. Anything having to do with the n, I need to substitute with k. Right. So n was starting with 2, now k starts with 0, ends with an infinity. N is k plus 2. N minus 1 is k plus 1. A is still A, but the subscript of A, the subscript of A was N, and N is A is k plus 2. So the subscript of A is now k plus 2. And then next I have x to the power, and the power used to be N minus 2, and now it's k, and that was my intention anyway. And the last step is just to rename k as the new n. So I have sum n from 0 to infinity, n plus 2, n plus 1, a n plus 2 x to the n. Okay, that's how I shift the index of, n, so that instead of having x to the power n minus 2, I end up with x to the n. Okay, when I first start out doing this, I would have to go through this new letter k, just so I don't get messed, so I don't mess things up. Okay. Once I get used to it, And what I see is this. If I want to go from n minus 2 to n, then basically I have to add 2 to everything, to every appearance of n, except that for every value, I have to go down by 2. It's like a phase shift on the x-axis. Okay, you go x plus 2, then the 2 becomes 0. And x, you shift to the right and the 2 becomes a 0. So n minus 2 becomes n. N minus 1, you plus 2 to it, you get n plus 1. N, you plus 2 to it, get n plus 2. And the n here is more like n plus 2 equals to 2, so n equals 0. So yeah, that's for later when you get used to it, then you can skip the k step. One more time, all the n's become n plus 2 add 2. So it used to be, this one used to be an n equals to 2. For the new n is n plus 2 is equal to 2, which is equivalent to n equals 0. And so that's how it works. Okay? All the old n becomes a new n plus 2. So new n plus 2 minus 2 is equal to just n. Right? So that's for when I'm used to it. Okay, until you get used to it, you can go through this intermediate step of using the letter K. Right? Now that you've seen how it works on the second sum, the first sum, the y double prime sum, let's do the same thing on this sum. Sum of n 0 to infinity of a n x to the n plus 1. I need to change this n plus 1 into just n. So if I do it in the shorthand kind of way, then n becomes n plus 1 becomes n. So all the n's are shifted up by 1. So the n itself becomes a new n minus 1. And new n is old n plus 1. So old n is new n minus 1 is equal to 0. So it's more like new n is equal to 1. So I'll be starting at n equals 1. Okay. So when I get used to it, that's how I'm going to do it. Okay. But I'm not used to it yet. So I'm going to go slow. I set k is equal to n plus 1. N is equal to k minus 1. N is equal to 0 correspond to k equals 1. And n equals infinity corresponds to k equals infinity. So I substitute everything in. I'm going to skip the part where I change color. I'm going to write everything in red. K equals 1 to infinity. A with subscript k minus 1. X to the power k. And I rename as n, sum of n from 1 to infinity, a n minus 1 x to the n, which is what I would have gotten if I taken the shortcut. So we're good. So now I have this sum, n from 0, to infinity, n plus 2, n plus 1, a sub n plus 2 x to the n minus the sum n from 1 to infinity, a sub n minus 1 x to the n. So I'm almost there. I got my like terms, okay? They're both times x to the power n, so I get my like terms. I just need to make sure they start at the same place. So here's the trick. Anything that doesn't match, I move them out. So this one, this second sum starts at n equals 1. This first sum starts at n equals 0. That means the first sum goes first with n equals 0. And they both start going with n equals 1. Right? So in other words, the first sum has a zero term that's kind of like extra, right? So, well, then I separate it out. So separate out n equals 0. So when n equals 0, I have 2 times 1 times a sub 2 of x to the 0 plus, and from 1 to infinity, n plus 2, n plus 1, a subscript n plus 2, x to the n minus 1 to infinity, a sub n minus 1, x to the n. So I have 2a subscript 2 plus, and then I can combine these together. Okay. Now there are a lot of theoretical stuff to consider, like radius of convergence and absolute convergence. And I need absolute convergence in order to merge two infinite series like this. Okay. But in terms of, you know, manipulation skills, we're going to leave that aside and pretend that it all works. And put them all together. I have some big stuff. I factor out the x to the n. And what I have in here is n plus 2 times n plus 1 times a n plus 2 minus a n minus 1. So all this is supposed to be equal to 0. And so anyway, now this is the end of my video, okay? My video is only intended to show you how to merge these two sums together by matching their indices. First of all, by matching the power of x, okay, so that you can combine like terms. And second of all, by matching the indices so that you can merge them all together into one big sum. And that part is actually the easier part. Just separate out anything that doesn't match, okay? The first sum has one extra term that doesn't match with the second sum, so I separate it out. And if you're gonna continue solving this, the whole thing's supposed to be equal to 0. So that means A2 is equal to 0. And this here is also supposed to be equal to 0, and that will get you your recursive relation. And if you work on this recursive relation, it looks pretty friendly to me. I haven't worked it all out yet, but it looks pretty friendly to me. So I sort of assume you'll be coming out to be some Taylor series that you can recognize. All right. Okay. So I hope that's been helpful. And I will see you later. Bye.